Good morning. Today we are going to discuss online learning, principles of successful e-learning, online education, and what are the features of online learning, and the last one, that is role of faculty in online learning. So these are all the important area that we would like to discuss today. So let us see first one, that is principles of successful e-learning. While we are discussing these principles, first one, that should match to the curriculum, that the method of teaching should match and be aligned with the suitable curriculum by means of clear objectives, content relevance, students' activity and appreciativeness. So teacher should select which methodology or with which method of teaching is suitable to achieve the predetermined objectives of our learning process. That's all about match to the curriculum. The next one, that is inclusion. That means the method of teaching should include, or it is helpful for catching the entire students by means of the methodology should include practice seen regarding different types, range of achievement and physical disabilities. Students may have several disabilities like poor internet connection, unavailability of computer or electronic gadget like this. So teacher should select suitable methods to achieve the learning objectives. And the next one, that is innovative approach. Teacher should consider innovative and novel method of teaching in order to attract the students and easy way of learning process. The next one, that is effective learning. That means teacher can demonstrate through by many ways using various approaches in the learning platform to permit the students to suit what suits him. The next one, that is related to the assessment. We know we have two assessment, that is formative assessment and summative assessment. Formative assessment means is a narrow concept, is an assessment which is conducted by the teacher to know the previous level of the previous knowledge of the students to start our or to begin our classes. Then summative assessment is the assessment which is conducted by the teacher to know the output or outcome of the learning practices. The next, that is consistency and transparency. Student activity and assessment should match with each other, and pedagogy or method of teaching should be internally consistent in matching the predetermined objectives of our learning process. Then it should be very easy of use. Learning should ensure easy of use and transparency. And the last one, that it should be cost effective. Technologies or any other means of e-learning process should be cost effective, and it is cheaper than traditional method of teaching. The next one, that is online education or online teaching. That means online education means getting knowledge or learning through online media. Is a simple meaning of online education. It's changing the face of in traditional classrooms and making education more accessible than ever before. Clear. Many definitions we have online education. Online education can be defined as an electronically supported learning that relies on the internet for a teacher or a student interaction and the distribution of classes, materials, etc. We are doing this same thing here now. Clear. Then a number of definitions we have, one of the definitions which is given in our video, GHAN 1997 defined online learning as the delivery of instruction to remote audience using the web as a intermediary. It's a definition which is given by GHAN in 1997. So now we see that different platforms or different programs under online courses. First one, that is 100% or 10% online education. The next one, hybrid education. And the third one, online courses. And the last one, that is MOOC. So let us see in one by one detail. 100% online education means is some universities or institutions which are offered their courses 10% online. They are offering some degrees as online mode. Clear. Then hybrid education means the students can pursue a combination of online and on-campus courses. Clear. So there, these universities or institutions are offering their courses, by selecting both mode, online and offline. That is called hybrid education. Then next, online courses. In such a situations, universities or institutions are offering their program as offline, and also they are offered some courses along with the offline degree courses. I will give an example for that. Suppose University of Calicut offering degree courses as an offline mode. It may offer one subject as online, like diploma in computerized accounting is an offline mode. So such a program is called offline courses. And the last one, that is MOOC. MOOC means massive open online courses, which is usually delivered lectures from online classroom with a large number of students. A number of courses are offered by this platform. Okay. Then now we can see nursing, business administration, criminal justice, accounting, computer information technology, early childhood education are the programs which are available on online mode to learn more and more. Clear. Now we can see the next, that is features of online learning. A number of features of online learning we have. Let us see one by one. First one, it is focus has shifted from teaching to learning. Now this is the era of online. Now students can able to learn by using their own platform, their own time, their own space, etc., etc. So the focus is shifted from teacher space to the learner space. That means the fundamental changes of the relationship between teacher and learner in online learning environment. Online pedagogy mainly focuses on the activities of the learner and sees teaching only a means of support. The next one, that is online learning is a student center. As already discussed here, learning process model has changed from a mere inputting model in which input consists of the present knowledge and the output is measured on what is known to them. Clear. The next one, development of learning environment. Teacher is always creating a learning environment by offering different supports or by giving supports to learner to collect the information from different sources and learn themselves. Clear. The next one, active. That means online learning is an active process. Online become competent to on manage and schedule their learning by themselves, because of teachers are uploading different videos for your subjects. Some of the students are actively involved by scheduling their time. They are downloading these videos, taking some notes and preparing some notes, etc., etc. Some of them are sleeping very well. Clear. So it's an active involvement in a positive sense. The next one, online learning should be interactive and collaborative. That means media enabled learner are empowered to interact with the content of the courses, with the instructor of the course and with the other learner in course. It is a collaborative mechanism of teaching and learning. Now next one, that is a role of faculty member in online teaching or online learning. While we are discussing online teacher, what is the role of this teacher in online? First one, that is organizing learners. That means organizing learners means defining the objectives, both the course level and module level are a key contribution of a faculty member. They have to decide what competencies or knowledge the learner will develop and why they are they important. Clear. This is an organizational and structural role of a faculty in online teaching. Teacher should develop learning objectives. Teacher should develop some methodology, pedagogy, etc. The next one, that is creation and selection. That means matching learning environment with the predetermined objectives of our learning. That means a faculty member is responsible for creating and procuring the educational activities that support the learning environment and assuming that they supported the objectives already determined. Clear. And then next one, that is related to the assessment. Teachers are also responsible for conducting different assessment to ensure that the students are able to achieve our learning objectives. Different kind of assessment can be done by using online mode, Google Form or Google Classroom, etc., etc. The next one, that is advisory and facilitator role. That means acting as the advisor or facilitator, providing individualized support. The instructor in the traditional classroom has these same requirements as online instructor. Suppose now we are uploading videos, now we are doing online classes.
clear, instead of traditional classes. Even though students can ask personal doubts through these online medias, in such a way teacher is acting as a supporter or a facilitator or a moderator. Clear. The next one, that is supporting learning strategies. That means online learning strives to provide mass customization in which the learner can develop the core competencies using learning strategies that are best for the end user or the learner. Then the last one, that is it's a collaborative method of learning. That means online learning can and should be collaborative effort from the teacher side and to the learner side. It's a collaborative effort of learning process. So these are all the important role of a faculty member in online. There are a number of advantages or positive aspects or negative aspect of these online teaching. The many important positive aspect of online teaching is, or online learning, is flexibility. Clear. Then a number of disadvantages of online teaching we have. Clear. So these are all the important areas which we would like to discuss today's video. Thank you to all.